Hi friends, this is the second section of the Spring Boot Security and JSON Web Token tutorial series. Today we'll be looking at the JSON Web Token structure. Also we'll be looking at what makes JSON Web Token self-reliant and secure. For this I'll be taking reference of my website javanews.com. Click on Web Series. In Web Series, go to Spring Boot Security JSON Web Token complete tutorial series. The tutorial that we'll be looking at today is understanding JWT structure. In this tutorial, we'll be understanding the JSON Web Token structure. So, in the first section of this tutorial series, we have already seen how JWT can be used for authorization. Also, we discussed that JWT is self-reliant to store all the necessary user information itself. In this tutorial, we'll look at how JWT makes this possible. A JSON Web Token, it consists of three parts or three sections. The first part is the header, then we have the payload, and finally we have the signature. All these three parts, they are separated by a dot. So, this is how an actual JSON Web Token looks like. Here we can see that this JSON Web Token, it has three parts and it is separated by these two dots. So the first part, that is this part, is the header section. Then we have the payload section. And finally here we have the signature section. All the three parts, they are in Base64 encoded format. Let us now have a look at each of these three parts of JWT and understand their functionality. So the first part is the header. The header, it consists of two fields. The first field is the type field. So the type, it is always JWT. And the second field is the algorithm field. So this algorithm specifies which algorithm should be used to digitally sign this JSON Web Token. So for this example, we are making use of the RS-512 algorithm to digitally sign this JSON Web Token. The next section that we'll be looking at is the payload section. So once a user has been successfully authenticated by the server, then this payload is created so that all the necessary information that is required for authorization in all the subsequent requests will be present in this payload. So in this payload, we specify the username, role, the expiration date. This expiration date is the date, that is the time till which this JSON Web Token is valid. So based on this payload information, the server will be able to make a decision whether the user should be granted access to a particular resource or not. The third section of the JSON Web Token is the signature section. So in this section, what the server does is that when creating this JSON Web Token, it base encodes the header and the payload to create the signature string, and then this signature string and the secret key, it is used along with this RS-512 algorithm to create a digital signature. So this is the string, that is the third part, that is created using the header, the payload and the secret key, and all these are then digitally signed using the RS-512 algorithm. Now suppose the server, on successful authentication, creates this JSON Web Token and returns it back to the user. On the subsequent request, the user will also be sending this JSON Web Token for authorization. Suppose when the user is sending this JSON Web Token to the server and there is a man in the middle attack. So the attacker will try to change the payload suppose. So this username he is changing to user2. Remember that all the three sections of the JSON Web Token, they are Base64 encoded. So anyone can be able to easily decode them. So a user can easily decode this payload and then change its content. We'll be later on seeing how this can be decoded in the example further. So now suppose the attacker, he has decoded and changed this username to user2. But the attacker, he cannot change the signature, that is the third section, because the attacker still does not have the secret key. Only if the attacker, he has access or he knows the secret key, will he be able to successfully tamper with this JWT. Now suppose the attacker, he does not have access or he does not know the secret key, because it will be available only to the server. So when the server will receive this tampered JSON Web Token, it will again create this signature using the payload and the header and also the secret key that it has, and then it will match the signature that it has just generated using this JSON Web Token using with the one that it previously has stored in this particular JSON Web Token, and it will know that yes, these both are not matching, so someone has tampered with this JSON Web Token. So whatever theory we just discussed, now let us practically implement it. So go to this link here, JWT Online Token Generator. We'll be creating a JSON Web Token for which we'll have to specify these claim information. All this claim information will go in the second section, that is the payload section of the JWT that we just discussed. So the issuer will be specifying it as JavaInews. Issue that I'll be keeping it as now. Expiration date, so we'll be keeping this JSON Web Token valid maybe for 20 minutes. Audience, I'll be giving it as JavaNews. Admin or subject, I'll be giving it as admin@javanews.com.
some additional claims that we have to submit. So I'll be just adding some additional claims here, such as the username. I'll be giving as user 1. Also, suppose the role will be giving it as admin. So this is the payload section that we have just specified about. This is the information that will be there in the payload. In the header, we'll be specifying the algorithm as maybe HS512. So this will go in the header, and this is the secret key using which the signature will be generated. So as discussed previously, the signature will be generated using this payload, the header information, as well as the secret key that I'm going to specify here. So the secret key, again, I'll just specify it as Java inUse. And I'll create a signed JSON web token. So this is the JSON web token that has been created. Copy this. So this is the JSON web token that has been created. The first section, it is the header section. Then we have the payload section. And finally, we have the signature section. So this signature section, it is the combination of the header and the payload section along with the secret key. And it is digitally signed using the HS512 algorithm. Again, copy this JSON web token that we have generated. Go to JWT.io. And here paste this JSON web token that we have created. So here it is showing the information. So all this information, it is in base64 encoded format. So here we can see the header, we have specified JWT, and the algorithm is HS512. Then this is the payload data that we have specified. And finally here, this is the algorithm HS512 that we have used, and base64 encoded format of the header and payload. And also, this it is a combination of the secret key, the last section that is there. So I'll be specifying the secret key here. So currently it is showing invalid signature. When I specify the signature as Java in use, it will show that the signature is verified. Now consider a scenario where suppose there has been a man in the middle attack and someone gains access to this JSON web token. He will obviously try to change the payload information, suppose. So copy this payload information, the second section, and go to this website base64encode.org. And click on decode. We need to decode this information first. So paste it here and decode. So we have decoded this payload section, and this is the information that the attacker will get. Suppose the attacker now changes this. Suppose the issuer, he makes it as Java in use 1. The username, he changes it to suppose user 3. Copy this information and go to encode section. And now he will again try to encode this section that he has modified. And this is the string that he will get. So this is the base64 encoded of the information that he has tampered with. And suppose he pastes it here. Now if we go here, we can see that invalid signature. We are getting this because we have given the secret key here. So the server will know that yes, the combination of these two sections and the secret key will not be able to this third section, that is the signature that has already been created by the server, which has access to the secret key. So as the secret key is available only with the server, the user and the server can communicate securely using JSON web token. Also, as can be seen here, that the JSON web token information where the payload section is only base64 encoded and anyone can decode it. So care should be taken that no sensitive information like password is sent in the payload section. Hope you have understood this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we'll be looking at Spring security architecture, as well as we'll be implementing an example to understand Spring Boot security for role-based authentication and authorization. Thank you.